Hi, my name is Andrew D'Ambrosi, and we're at Bergen Hill, and today for Fork and Plate, we'll be showing you how to make a really awesome tomato sauce. All right, so here's how we start with the awesome tomato sauce. Rule number one, and very important, a good amount of olive oil in the pot, cold. Do not turn the pot on yet. And then we got this shaved garlic, sliced very thin. We're gonna throw it in the pot also, not on. Now we're gonna turn it on. And here's the most important part, is that we have to actually watch this and keep it moving the entire time in order for all the garlic to toast in uniform fashion before we throw in the tomatoes and render down as fast as possible. This is the number one mistake I think most people make when they actually try to make a tomato sauce. This is the best way to make tomato sauce, I promise you. So the purpose of doing this is actually starting from cold, is giving time for the oils from the garlic to release into the oil, essentially flavoring the oil with garlic. And even right now you can start to see slightly, it's starting to kind of turn brown. And then once it's brown, it's go time. And now the garlic's toasted, we're gonna throw in the tomatoes. So once you put the tomatoes in, for the first part, first about 5 minutes, you're okay to not stir, or it's not absolutely necessary to stir. But after that moment, it's gonna start to stick. And as it cooks down more and more, it's gonna continue to stick. So you constantly have to stir it, otherwise you'll have burnt tomato sauce, and that's a huge no-no. So as you see, we cooked it down. It's been about 15 minutes, give or take, maybe even 20, depending on the amount of tomatoes and how hot the burner you're using. But what we wanna do is get it dry as possible. You see it's pretty dry now, and what you wanna check for to see that when you put your spoon through it, it takes a minute for it to come back and fold over. That's how dry it is. This means at this point now, it's like a paste, and it's gonna cling to your pasta. So at this point, we're gonna add the salt, keeping in mind that we just wanna add salt to season it, just to the point. Before it gets too salty, especially considering once we cool it off, you may want to add capers or something that may bring up a little bit more salinity, or even olives. So we're gonna transfer this to a tray to cool off. Reason being is because, you know, a lot of people add their herbs in hot, like basil. I do not recommend that, obviously, when it's hot, because it'll kill off the basil. And it will just die and the flavors won't be fresh. So now that tomato sauce, as you can see, it's quite thick. Now that it's cooled off, at this point you can add whatever you wish. For me, I'm gonna do a little more traditional. I'm just gonna add a little bit of basil and caper, but now that it's cold, so now it'll store nicely. Also, if I did add the capers hot, they have a tendency to bleed out the salinity into the sauce. So again, I'm gonna add them when it's cold, so it's gonna be just the pop of the caper and then the basil, just to give it a little bit of herbage. But from here, you can add lobster in there, you can drop truffles, you can drop gold fronts, shoes, keys, whatever you want. It's all up to you. So again, this is Andrew D'Ambrosi at Bergen Hill Restaurant in Brooklyn for Fork and Plate, making you awesome sauce, but also really dry. So the liquid will reduce really fast, hopefully, and we'll be able to keep the tomatoes kind of in a nice, delicious texture. What? What am I even saying? I'm like fucking just making up words. So get a really big spoon and a towel and make sure you wipe up after, because your station's gonna be a mess, or your house. Sorry, not a station, you're not in a restaurant. Are you? sorry. But that's what it should look like, essentially. It should look really nice and thick. Delicious, yummy. When we do season it, you don't wanna season too much, because once it cools off, that's the time when we're gonna add things like maybe capers, maybe basil, or anything that may, well, shut up, Andrew, shut up, fucking basil, fucking basil.
Can you tell the
joke?
No more?
Plop.